Welcome to already our second day of the MOOC transport phenomena. Today we're going to go to a wastewater treatment plant to find out how they use transport phenomena in order to treat our wastewater. Let's go!
This is the wastewater treatment plant Harnaspolder. We clean the water for nearly a million people in this area. One of the cities is Delft and the other one is The Hague. We show you the transport phenomena in this process. Welcome at the wastewater treatment Harnaspolder. This is the first treatment step in the process. We filter the wastewater that is arriving at the plant. You can see how it works in this picture. The particles bigger than 6 millimeters are blocked and removed from the process. This is one of the 5 step streams we use. With the step stream we remove big particles bigger than 6 millimeters, and that is to avoid problems in the process later. As you can see, tissue is removed, condoms, and a lot of waste. We are standing now near a final clarifier. Water that comes in with the activated sludge is entering the tank in the middle. As you can see, the water is a little bit brownish. The brown water is then settled in the tank. The activated sludge is removed from the water and transported back to the biological tanks. The wastewater is entering the middle of the tank, as you can see. In the tank, the activated sludge is settled and the wastewater that is being cleaned is flowing over at the edges of the tank. Each liter of wastewater that is entering the tank is going out of the tank at the same time. It's a continuous flow. The cleaning process is now done. Let's go to the transport pumps. Here we are standing in front of the effluent pumping station. The clean water is transported from here to the North Sea. The capacity of one pump is 1750 kilowatts. That is about 200 households, the consumption. Let's go inside and take a look. We are now standing in the effluent pumping station. The wastewater that has been cleaned is transported to the North Sea. One pump is needed per day during dry weather. The capacity of the pump is 13 million liters per hour. This is the last step of the treatment process of the wastewater.
Well, that was super interesting to see how transport phenomena are used in this water treatment plant. Let's go back to the studio and take a closer look at one of the examples given today, namely the mass balance.